What's going on, my fellow Guardians? Your dude Sly here, and we have officially entered Gamescom weekend. All sorts of interviews, live streams, and gaming goodness is happening as we speak. And also, in a recent live interview, some new Shadowkeep footage that was playing in the background of a recent Inside Xbox interview showed off a ton of new things that we have yet to see. The most interesting was a sneak peek at how artifacts work and a new game mode called Nightmare Hunt. We also now know the name of one of the new Shadowkeep strikes, so if you're looking to keep Shadowkeep spoiler-free, turn back now. But if not, let's dive into it. Our first topic, guys, artifacts. Now, we had artifacts back in Destiny 1, but they were kind of like an additional talent that activated in certain situations. But with the upcoming artifact, there are a bunch of choices that can cover a wide range of armor and weapons. Originally, I thought artifact slots were going to stay the same. You know, you could just select a few additional talents, and that would be it. Turns out I was really wrong, and as it so happens, the perks located in your artifacts are actually armor and weapon mods. Now, this is not 100% confirmed. I'm only going by what the video had to offer, because in the interview they really didn't talk about artifacts at all. It's just the video they showed was pretty revealing, so that's what we're going to be talking about, and some of the details may be off. But from what I could tell, the artifact unlocks a whole row of unique and powerful mods. Now, there are mods that changes our melee, grenade, energy such as void, arc, hand cannons, SMGs, and all other kinds of weapons and armor mods. So remember back to the Armor 2.0 reveal stream, Deed showed off one of the enhanced perks, such as the enhanced hand cannon reloader. As we found out, each armor piece has 10 energies to spend on mods. The more powerful the perk or talent, the more it's going to cost. Well, hand cannon reload perk costs you 3 energies, while the enhanced version costs 5. Well, the artifact here is no different. Some of the more powerful mods even go above 5 and can cost as high as 7 energies, such as the one you see here, while others seemingly cost little to none, such as this hand cannon mod known as the anti-barrier hand cannon. Now, the whole champions thing we'll get to a little bit later on. So now, how does this artifact work, and can we choose from all of them? Well, from what I can tell, there are a couple of things at play here. If you stop the video at just the right frame, you can read some info about the artifact. It says, Gatelord's Eye. The charged eye of a Vex Gatelord can be used to infiltrate the most protected layers of their network, whoever they are, and reverse engineer to confer incredible powers to its bearer. Lasts until the end of the Season of Undying. It also shows unlocks available as 12, how many you've unlocked so far, and then a power bonus at the bottom. As we open up the artifact to enter the menu, it shows the number of unlocks available at the very top left. As Thundercoil is bought, it brings it back down to 1. So you can see however many you purchase, it'll tell you in the top how many you have left. However, the stuff on the bottom right hand side, I don't quite understand yet. I'm assuming it means that we have maxed out the upgrade of the artifact, and that we are now able to purchase 12 out of the possible 12 mods that we can get at any one time. Even though we have 2 available to unlock, we still have the opportunity to buy 12. The power bonus, I have absolutely no idea where that comes from. Basically, you can go through and choose what kind of mod you think will fit your style the most, or what'll give your team the biggest edge in whatever game mode you're playing. So let's take a look at the ones revealed so far. First, we have Thundercoil, a class item mod. Grants bonus damage for all arc melee abilities and refunds super energy on finisher final blows. It costs 6 energy to equip. Next is Arc Battery. Grants overshield and reduced cooldown during activation for all arc class abilities. Then we have Oppressive Darkness. Causing damage with a void grenade adds a weakening effect to enemies. And finally, the most expensive at 7 energies, Heavy Finisher. Finishers generate heavy ammo, requires 1/2 of your super energy. In fact, you can see that in action right here. It's also worth noting that this finisher will drop ammo for your entire team, not just for yourself. That's one of the things they did mention within the interview. Take a look at the super bar draining right here, and then notice the addition of purple ammo as the player continues forward. It's also worth mentioning that you can tell when a combatant is ready for a finisher by the orb above its head. If you see an enemy running around that has that, you know, little circle orb above its head, that means you can run up to it and complete a finisher. Alright guys, moving on to the other side that's been revealed, we have anti-barrier rounds for auto rifles and SMGs, shield-piercing rounds designed to bypass combatant defenses, strong against barrier champions. And the next one is the same thing except for hand cannons, which we've seen earlier. And just as the video exits, we get a glimpse of overload rounds for ARs and SMGs. Uninterrupted fire grants bullets that cause disruption, delaying ability energy regeneration and lowering combatant damage output. Strong against Overlord champions. And as you can see right below it, the bow has pretty much the same background as this AR and SMG overload mod, so I'm assuming that it grants the same thing as this mod, except of course it's for bows. We can also glimpse at some of the familiar looking mods to the right hand side of it as well. Those plus signs are enhanced mods of some kind, so it could be a way for those who don't like to complete, you know, pinnacle activities to get enhanced reload mods or something like that. Maybe enhanced handling, you know, range, I really have no idea. So I'm just totally guessing here, but it does look something like that. Also, I don't know if this is the only artifact available or if these mods will switch or rotate with other mods in like a larger menu. I'm not entirely sure. But this is the most information we've seen from the artifact thus far, and so far it looks pretty interesting. The biggest revelation, at least I think for me, is the fact that these are all armor and weapon mods and not something dedicated to the artifact itself. I thought the artifact would be something we could activate just within the artifact, and that would then grant a bonus to our overall character. I didn't realize that these were actually going to be separate mods that we pick from this pool to then, you know, spread across our character in way of armor and weapon mods. So I think that's pretty cool. Now the other thing I noticed while looking through the gameplay is called Unstable Essence. Now notice the countdown on the left hand side. As the player uses a finisher, another orb then pops up and refreshes the countdown. This could be another artifact mod. But anyways, this leads up into our next batch of new information, the activity they're in right now, and that's a new game mode or game type called Nightmare Hunt. Now, I don't think this will be anything as grand as like the Blind Well or other game modes like it, but it seems like mostly seek and destroy type of missions here that refresh weekly. However, they do seem to be quite the challenge. As you can see, there are three difficulties here. We have Adept, Hero, and Legend, which are brand new namings for Shadowkeep. All difficulties have some kind of modifier on them, and looking at the numbers, this will seemingly be an endgame mode. Adept only has one modifier called Air Superiority. Hero, which is 60 power levels higher than Adept, has three additional modifiers for a total of four, Champion Overload and Barrier, along with something called Torment of Zydron. And finally, we have the last one called Legend. Now, I cannot tell you how long I've been waiting to see the highest difficulty in Destiny be called Legend. I mean, it's been begging for it forever. Anyways, it's an additional 30 levels higher in terms of like power level and two more modifiers than Hero for a total of six. Equipment is locked, and then we have Match Game as the two additional ones. Now, from what I can tell, guys, Nightmares are former bosses from previous DLCs and raids. Now, I don't know if they will feature similar mechanics as their original fight, or if it's going to be a straight-up shoot fest. But, as you look around, you can tell there are quite a few Nightmare Hunts spread around the moon, and hopefully, they are on other worlds as well. Okay, so moving on here, we're kind of winding things down, but the last two bits of information left to talk about are a new strike and a new exotic. First, the new strike coming with Shadowkeep is of course on the moon, and it's called Scarlet Keep. Investigate the recently erected Scarlet Keep and discover its dark purpose. Power level is 750, so that's the same level as we're at today. And finally, guys, let's talk about a couple of exotics. Now, Monte Carlo has been guessed at for quite some time, but as you can see right here, Monte Carlo is definitely coming with the next DLC. And on top of that, a brand new exotic will arrive as well, a hunter helmet called the Assassin's Cowl. Defeating a guardian with a melee attack or a combatant with a finisher grants invisibility, restores a portion of health and shield. So this thing sounds pretty ridiculous. Add in some original mods or perhaps even artifact mods, and you're looking at one pumped up helmet. But that is about it, Guardians. Besides a couple of good shots showing off each class's finisher, that's really about it. A lot of this wasn't talked about in the interview itself, but pictures are louder than words, and these little snippets told us a ton of stuff we didn't know. Again, this is early information, so some of this could change or I could be mistaken in my presumptions, which unfortunately happens fairly often. But anyways, guys, that is about it. As always, thank you for watching and for supporting Sly Nation. There's a lot more Gamescom to go as we are just getting started today. On Monday is the very first day, so keep it here as I'll be busting out any news concerning Destiny 2 Shadowkeep and Cyberpunk 2077. If you're new to my channel, then welcome, my friend. Subscribe for lots more Destiny 2, Cyberpunk 2077, Anthem, Fallen Order, and other open world RPG news. Spank the thumbs up, but only if you enjoyed yourself, and if you're creeping around social media, feel free to check me out on Twitter or Facebook at Sly Nation or Sly Nation Gaming on the FB. later, Guardians, and keep those eyes open for more vids coming out soon. But until then, this is your dude Sly, and I'll catch you all next time.